coming. This is our first concert for 2020, but this is we realize this is our 10th anniversary of our first concert. March. Does all the bookkeeping, knows exactly how many events in the last 10 years, concerts, workshops, walking tours, etc. It's
all of it. We're up to 293 today.
And you know our concerts are free and to the general public, and you know that performers just come and they don't charge us for that. So it's and Celeste does a great job with organizing. You know how it is, so you're in for a very good treat. The theme is, again, it's the women's suffragette. This is the 100th anniversary, and we do, if you saw the presentation downstairs, we do have suffragettes who are behind me, who are buried here, who worked very hard on the to ratify the 19th Amendment. And so we need to, cell phones off, you know.
That's right, we can
turn them off. Oh, we do have tissues, we do have,
lotion, sanitizers.
This afternoon, after the concert, at the reception, Dovalone, who has done our desserts for the last couple of years now, is doing a special three-color cheesecake. Purple, white, and gold. All right, so we'll be splitting them up, and we have forks, and we'll hand them out. You just got to be very patient. We'll
Caprice I'm going to play is called El Pajarito,
which depicts, yeah, that depicts a cage, a little bird in a cage. And what she says about that one, she says, this is her writing, music is a language. So let's describe here the soul of this tiny bird, describing what he went through after becoming aware of where he was. Gentle first, desperate and resigning, because hopeless and helpless. Okay, so, two caprices by Eckhardt-Gramatté.
Thank you. Janine Tesori is a local from New York. She grew up in Fort Washington, and she's considered the most prolific and honored female theatrical composer in history, with 5 Broadway musicals and 5 Tony Award nominations. Her most groundbreaking work included the musical Fun Home, where Tesori and her lyricist, Lisa Krohn, were the first female composing team to ever win a Tony Award for Best Original Score. So I'm going to sing this song in the honor of women who are breaking the ceiling in theater.
The wonders of the world are said to stop at 7, but truth to tell, my figures don't agree. I would number them at 8. With one so close to heaven, the others pale, their magic stale. Just take a look and see. Step right up to Treasure Isle. Every inch of it, a sky high mile. Fairy tale land.
Move on over, move on over.
Thank you. Waiting at the station with a workday window blow.
House to house, to secure the enrollment of women who believed that women of New York State should vote. At our monthly meetings, we invited guest speakers to give talks and lectures about the cause. We also had block parties and concerts to raise funds. In 1918, the Morris Park Suffrage Club joined the larger Queens Suffrage Association, and I became its treasurer. The suffragettes had what they called silent sentinels, groups of women who were posted outside the White House with picket signs. Many of these silent sentinels were arrested by municipal authorities and imprisoned. It was a shocking moment in the history of women's rights, women being imprisoned and in some cases force-fed when they started hunger strikes in prison. Eventually, women gained the right to vote in states like New York in 1919. There was a serious campaign to add the proposed 19th Amendment to the US Constitution that would give women the right to vote. They convinced President Woodrow Wilson to support women's suffrage and the proposed 19th Amendment. Finally, by June of 1919, the Congress had passed and endorsed the proposed 19th Amendment, and it was ratified on August 18, 1920, to the United States Constitution, ending almost a century of protest. Women began voting across the United States en masse in the presidential election of 1920. I am happy to state that I was one of those women to cast my hard-earned vote in that election. Thank you for coming.